Hallo, ich bin Noah Wirtschritz. Ich komme aus Holland und ich spiele Geige. Und ich bin hier in Mecklenburg-Vorpommern und ich spiele bei den Festspielen Mecklenburg-Vorpommern diese Woche. When I was two, I started playing the cello. I come from a musical family, so all string instruments in my family. My mother plays the violin, is a violin teacher. My father plays the viola, and my sister played the violin at that time and now plays the viola too. And I wanted to have the biggest instruments of the family, so that's why I chose the cello first. But somehow it wasn't quite what I had in mind, and the violin fits me better. So when I was four, I decided to go for the violin, and I still play on it. Well, I was two when I started playing the cello, so you can start at a very young age. I think my sister was three when she started playing the violin. I was four when I started playing the violin. But yeah, you can actually start at any age, and even when you're grown up, you can still start learning it. But I think you're really flexible when you're that young, so you learn everything very quickly, and that's goes a bit slower, I think, at a older age, but I think when you're a teenager, you can still really perfectly learn how to play a string instrument or any instrument. It's very different to play in an orchestra than playing in front of an orchestra, so playing as a soloist with the orchestra. And playing in an orchestra is all about communicating, and you mostly with the Symphony Philharmonic Orchestra, you have a conductor, which because the orchestra is so big, and the conductor is actually the one who is in charge of the whole orchestra. So the orchestra becomes one instrument, and the conductor actually is the leader of that instrument. And playing in an orchestra is all about communicating and doing it together as a group and being one voice. And as a soloist, I'm playing, for example, a violin concerto in front of the orchestra. You have very virtuosic passages, but also, of course, you get to play all the important melodies and everything. And what I like when I play violin concerto with an orchestra, it's also, for me, it's the most fun to also communicate with the people around me, so the people in the orchestra. And sometimes I have a melody which, yeah, is actually together with another instrument from the orchestra. So, for example, sometimes I have a melody with the cello players. So it's such great fun to do that, to communicate with them then, and I'm standing next to the first violin section, and it's such great fun to have this feeling of doing it all together, even though you get to play the solo part. It's a very good question how you actually produce sound, because we are playing and actually not thinking about it anymore, how everything happens, because it's such a special thing that you have a bowl with some horse hair, and then instruments made of wood mostly, and then strings of steel. And if you just do this, you make sound. That's actually very special. And of course, it's a very complicated construction, and there are many things that make the sounds work. So I have some rosin here, which actually you put on your bow, and then you do it like this. It's a frog at the tip, and then So vibrato is a tool, a movement with your finger. So you wiggle with your finger like this. And sometimes you play non-vibrato, so without vibrato, then it sounds like this. And if you use vibrato, it sounds like this. And then you have lots of different kinds of vibrato too. So you can play very small movements, very fast, for example. I'll show it. And you can also make bigger movements, and then it sounds like this. And then within the playing, you actually use all different kinds of vibrato, and that actually creates different colors and different characters, because when we play, we try to tell a story, actually, not with words, but with sounds. And you can play, for example, really soft or really loud, and very also articulation, so very short. Or long notes like I did before. So you can do so many things that make it colorful and that helps you to tell us a musical story. Well, when I was younger, I had a smaller instrument. So a full-size instrument I've had since I was 12. When I was 12, I got an Italian Concino violin. And now I'm playing on a Guadagnini violin from 1750, also from Italy. And yeah, so two full-size instruments. And before that time, I grew and everything. So I started with, like, I think 1/4 size of this. And it built up. And when I was 12, I was able to handle a full-size instrument. And I'm now 20 years old. And I play on this instrument for almost 2 years now. Yeah, it is indeed almost like a relationship with an instrument, because I take them everywhere I go, and it's also about a personal connection with an instrument, because I also tried out many different violins, and it's all about what you want to express in the music. So some people like a more dark violin, more dark color, but I think this one also is very warm and has a round sound, but at the same time also fresh, and that it's sparkly as well. So that's what I like about this violin, that it has all these colors in it.